We shall learn how to create a simple data entry form in MVC. For our purposes, we shall create a form like this: name, text box, phone, text box, and a save button. When a user clicks this save button, this data will be taken to a database and stored there. For this, we shall create a model called CUserData with a field called username and a user phone. So we shall be working on this model. If this is your form, this is for name and this is for phone, then we have to establish a link between these two fields and the model. A property on the model called name will be mapped to this text box, and a property called phone will be mapped to this text box. When the save is clicked, an object of CUserData will be created, and these properties will be set by reading this name and phone text box. So let us see how to do this. Let us begin by adding a controller called home controller. To this home controller, we have added an action method called index. This action method is taking an argument of the type CUserData. This is not related in any way to the data entry form. The sole purpose is to display a user data here. It is only for displaying. So whatever user data object will come to this index, that will be passed to the view, and on the view we have, this is the model that is coming, CUserData. This is the model that is coming from here, and we are displaying the phone here. Phone is equal to @model.userphone, and name will be displayed here @model.userphone. This is not the data entry form but the display form for data. So it is just a helper that we have created, and what is worth noting here is that we have also created a link button, a click to create a new record. For this, let us first of all display whatever we have till now. You will understand it better. So this is what our index action displays here. It displays a link button for click new record and some data. Phone is empty, name is empty because nothing has been passed to this. So it is just a display and a link button where we will click to reach the data entry form. So let us now see how to create that data entry form first. To our home controller, we have added another action method called createRecord. It is returning a view. So this will be basically showing us the data entry form. And the view for this is, it looks like this. This is the data type of the model that comes into this. The form is created by starting this tag @using html.beginForm. So what this does is, @ HTML dot begin form, and these curly braces. They translate into an HTML that looks like this: angle bracket form, method is post, and it closes here. All form data on an HTML page must be inside the form tags, and there must be a button called submit button. When this button is clicked, the data inside this form tag, inside the input elements, that is posted to the server. So before we write any input button, input tags, or the submit button, we must have an empty form tag. An empty form tag can be created by writing @HTML.beginForm. Next we have added span name, input type is text, name is username. This one creates a text box. In MVC, we do not have a toolbox from where to bring in the items. We have to code it manually. So here we are writing angle bracket input, type is text, and name is username. This will render a text box for us because its type has been set equal to text. If we set its type to radio, then radio buttons. If we set its type to a checkbox, then checkboxes. So this is the way we create user interface elements in HTML using the input tag. If you are coming from an ASP.NET background, then this would be very new to you. For a PHP developer, this is common, and there also all input elements are created with the input tag. Since we are to deal with raw HTML, we have to be aware of these input type of text boxes. The interesting thing is that if we want this input element to map to our model property called username, then its name property must case to case tally with the property there. In our case, our model is having a property called username. So its name attribute should be set exactly equal to username. Coming back to the screen, we have name, input type is text, name is username, input type is text, name is user phone, and there is a submit button, input type is submit and value is save. Let us first see how it renders on the screen. Click on create record, it will take us to the appropriate action. And we will we'll get the display here. So here we are having this name, a text box for phone, and a save button. View source. And this is the HTML that is generated for us. Angle bracket form closes. Input type is text, name is username, phone type is text, name is user phone, button submit save, and method is post. When the user clicks this form, this save button, this data will be posted back to where? See the source property here. It will be posted back to the same action called create record. We are in this action called create record, and the data will be posted back to the same action. Here we have added a same action method called create record, the same name. It accepts an object of CUserData, and on it we have annotated it as HTTP post. So when the user clicks this submit button, this data will be posted to this function or this action method, and whatever has been entered by the user there, that will be available to us at this point. Let us put a breakpoint. The breakpoint is hit, and what is the data that is coming to us? We can examine here. The data is coming in the form of two fields. Username is Hovan, user phone is phone Hovan. This means we have been successful in sending this form data to our action method, which was created it as HTTP post. Here we can write our code to store this item into database. We are not showing that code right now because our purpose is to illustrate the concept right now. In the next line, we are writing redirect to action called index and pass this object to that. So what will happen is that after the record is stored into database, our call will be redirected to this action. That is, we'll come back to the home page, but this time the two data would be shown there. So let us now do that also. So here this time user data is shown, phone Hovan and Hovan, and we are back to our index method. Let me summarize the whole process. To create a data entry form, you will first of all use html.beginForm. This will render the form tag for us. Then you should write any input tags, but you will have to be careful about the name property. This property must match your model property. You are having a second input. Its name matches a model property. And finally, you should have a submit button here. When this button is clicked, this input value is stored in the property that is listed here. This input value will be stored in the property that is listed here, and object will be passed to an action method having an annotation HTTP post action result. And the name of the action method, create form or create whatever. And this model, CUserData, is passed into this. Here you can do whatever you want with this data. So this is the complete summary. Create a form. Give these names the same name as the properties in your model, and create an action result with the HTTP annotation. This action method should have the same name as the one that was used for reaching this page. And this time, this is a second overload. This should accept an argument of the type model. See user data dat.